All right, my favorite people, Sterling White here, back at it again with another topic for you here in Houston, Texas. Well, I live here, so I can just say that in just about every video, but they say everything's bigger here. Since I've moved here, the only thing that I would say I'm disappointed about is the toilets are the same size as the ones back home. So they say everything's bigger, but that was not the case, or I just may have a defective toilet. But today's topic is on, should I wait until this housing market cools down to buy? So just simply answering this question. So you'll definitely want to stay tuned until the very end. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and answer this question for you, which is no. That's the end of the video. No, just kidding. Stay tuned. So just rolling right into it. As long as you are sticking to the fundamentals, which is buying right, financing right, which means buying right is not overpaying for a property. Financing right is not putting too much debt onto the property, which could be 80% loan to value, 90% loan to value, 100% loan to value. And then the next is buying in good to great locations. And then the last but not least is managed right, because you can do all those things up front properly, but if you don't manage the property properly, then that's when you can turn a good deal into an actual bad deal. And this goes back to just a case study that I do want to share with you, is when it comes to buying in good to great locations. So I remember that when in full acquisitions mode, that was scaling on the single family side, is that when we were buying in solid C neighborhoods and then also some B neighborhoods, that the price points that we needed to now buy the properties for and then renovate and then sell, and then, or either more so we were just renting, that return that we were once getting just a couple years before, we weren't. So we were actually having to go down into some not so good areas, I would say. And those looked good on paper, but I tell you now is that the actual execution is very difficult to do. One, more management intensive. And then also one thing you have to consider is that in these tougher neighborhoods, is you really slim down your pool of quality residents, because quality residents don't want to live in tough neighborhoods. They don't want to raise their kids there. Some, unfortunately, just not able to afford to be in the nicer or desirable locations. And in the case, they have to live there. But as soon as they're able to actually upgrade their lives and make more, they're looking to get out of that as soon as possible. Tell me how I know, because one, those are the deals I would buy, but then also that when my mother moved both my brother and I out from the inner city of just, I remember we lived in the Meadows, which if anyone's familiar with Indianapolis, the Meadows is very rough. And that every day it sounded as if there was gunshots outside, or not gunshots, but fireworks, but they actually were gunshots. And other neighborhoods, we bounced around quite a bit. And I just remember my freshman year of high school, I went to 5 different schools. Yes, 5 different schools, but we finally moved out from the inner city to more the suburbs. We were still in lower income housing, but completely different of the schooling and then also the people we're around. And then that's when I was able to take a completely different trajectory in life. Unfortunately, my brother went back to that environment that we grew up in and took a different trajectory in life. So that really just goes to show the not the forks in the road, but how environment really plays a play. And many parents are aware of that, so they want to get their kids out of those types of settings. And going back to buying right, so bought a deal. This was Buckridge at, no, actually, I'm going to use another example. So Remington on Rockville, bought this a year and a half ago and bought it for just over $6.2 million. Actually went direct to owner to buy it. So was able to get a discount, and minimally a broker said they would have listed that for $7 million, but got it for $6.2 million. With that, received offers just most recently, so about a year later, of what on our actual 3-year projections on that. And we're not even through our reposition, like we're not even through our reposition. So that goes to show you how important it is to buy right. And then when it comes to financing right, it's just not, and this is a mistake that most people made, is, and I'm a firm believer that yes, it's good to learn from your own mistakes, but it's even better to learn from others. So by putting too much debt on the property, is yes, it does look good on your returns. However, let's say, I don't know, a pandemic happens to happen, then rents start to pull back and you're not able to get as much income coming in. However, your debt is still higher, and then now you may have to come out of pocket, if you can come out of pocket, to pay that difference, if there likely is a difference in that case. And then just the last one, managing right, is that, yeah, just having a good team, property management company, or you do in-house yourself, is just ensuring that you're doing the good asset management and the property is performing accordingly. So that's what I really just want to mention, is that for those, I'm still prospecting and look for deals, haven't bought anything this most recent deal, but I just know it's a truly patience play, and just still planting those seeds, and then I know in the future that they will start to sprout. But with that, is I'm okay, is that I just know consistently is sticking to the fundamentals and not varying from that. Some have shifted their models. I have shifted the model a bit, but still sticking to the fundamentals. That is crucial. And this one, it goes back to this example of learning from others. So recently was at the Bigger Pockets Conference, BPCon, that was in New Orleans. And I spoke with an investor, Brian Burke, who's been in the industry for a very lengthy time, I believe closer to about 30 years or so. Shout out to him. And one of the questions I asked him was, what mistakes did you see people make? Because this is where people, when I answer the question, should I wait until this housing market cools down to buy, is that there's still some people that are in a frenzy. So I was asking them that, okay, well, what is something that people can avoid to not get into that frenzy and feel they have to buy deals? And he said that, one, It's okay that we're still having difficulties buying deals, and we're not putting too much debt onto the property. And then also, you want to ensure that you raise money to take care of reserves, so when bad times do happen, that you can tap into your reserves to address that. But the thing is that when you don't put much leverage onto your property and you raise money for reserves, is that does affect your investors' return. But it's being okay with that and passing on deals until you hit ones that reach those metrics. That way, yes, if you go past your metrics and you disregard those, that yeah, you could buy the deal now, but then as history repeats itself, you could run into that issue in the future. So that's one thing I always want to share with you all, is I'm not perfect by any means, but I just want to share my lessons that I've learned as an entrepreneur, investor in the industry. And that way you can avoid common mistakes, pitfalls, potholes that people have made. So I appreciate you all so much. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe. Those of you who are on the YouTube, if you're in the shower or driving or anything, you're listening to this on the podcast, leave that rating. It would really mean the world. So, and those of you who would want to personally speak with myself, or someone on the team to just further get insights on how to scale your business and where to bridge the gap from where you are to where you want to go, there is a link below to a set up a call strategy session, which is about 30 to 45 minutes. So thank you. Enjoy.